Hello, Beth and Matt. Rory Callahan here. Thanks for your patience, for starters, and for letting me revise this. In all honesty, I had kind of painted myself in a corner with this kitchen because it was so small, and I didn't come up with the plan to move the range to the other side. Although we had talked about it, I didn't think it was practical in your house. I think it can actually be done. Simply a matter of getting the gas from where it is to where it needs to be, and we can do that by going under the floor or over and around if we have to. So I'm not really worried about it. And whether you pick a 30-inch range or a 24, this is going to work. This is about the best kitchen that I can come up with here. I can even put a wall in here that conceals clutter and cooking from the entryway, but it doesn't have to be here. We're going to look at a 3D view in a minute, but I want to start with these elevations. This, of course, familiar to you, this side. And I would use a relatively narrow refrigerator. Cabinet here with a roll out drawer. The sink base, the reason I did it with a single door like this is I can have, I put a little swing out waste basket in here. You're so tight for space, but that would be handy. If you don't want it, you don't have to get it, but I put it in. This cabinet is deep enough. You'll see in a 3D. We'll go to the 3D in a minute, but then let's go to this side first. So there's, we can put a microwave in here in a cubby if you want to get it off the counter. And I have a photograph of that in the email to show you. These cabinets are high enough to be, let's see, that's, I got 25. This is over 6 feet off the floor. So easy for you to reach, Matt. All right, let's look at the3D viewer. Going to take a minute to bring that up. And okay, so here's the wall I was describing, which does not have to be here if you don't like that look. I'll give you an alternative to this, too, this wall right here. Whoops. Uh-oh, what the heck? Okay, if you were interested, for starters, you don't need the wall at all. The countertop can just be all one level. We could put bookshelves on the backside. You could store a lot of books in here if you wanted to have that be like an integral piece of furniture that matches the kitchen. I can't do it up to this height because this piece is taller than this window, but we could get real close. We could still do the concept. All right. Because it's a small kitchen, it's hard to really dive in the 3D, but I think you still should be able to get a pretty clear understanding. This cabinet is deep, lots of storage here. The panel just provides some separation to give the refrigerator a little bit more of a fitted appearance. And you know, I popped this tile backsplash in here, but in your quote, I just went ahead and quoted it in matching granite. It's a small room, but to have a tile mechanic come in and you incur expense there, it would probably cost more to do this in tile than it would in just letting it be granite. But if you like the look of changing that texture and material up, then that's a good way to do it. I would, actually this shows like a crown, a real traditional crown. With that door style, I'd kind of be inclined to just use a straight piece of wood. And I'll show you examples of that. I think it's a great little kitchen, all right? So let's move on to the quote. Oh, before I do, full-size sink 18-inch dishwasher, which is a compact dishwasher, but it holds three-quarters of the amount of stuff you'd get into a full-size. So, all right, let's take a look at the numbers. I priced it out four ways. I priced it out in the paint grade maple, both typical and FSC documented, and the same thing for mahogany. And to summarize what I wrote in my way too lengthy email, this is a complicated and convoluted issue. There are cheaters within the FSC system, evidently. There are a lot of honest people, too. My guys, I know they're honest. It's just their nature. They can buy the wood and prove that it's FSC certified at the source, but they cannot get a chain of custody because they're not technically FSC members, which is a tremendous amount of work. So they're just not going to do that. Compounding the problem are sellers that cheat and lie and produce false FSC documentation. So these guys do their best, and as do their wholesalers, the people who import the wood, but sometimes you just really don't know what you're working with there. In any case, so to build you that white painted door that you liked, the cabinetry, everything you just saw in that plan comes to $96.90. And this number here is legitimate. If you were to walk into a showroom that sold a product like the product that I'm building for you, this is where the money would be. If you want that same kitchen, but you want it FSC documented, it's going to cost you about another $2,100. Same thing if you go to mahogany. All right, so there you have it. Granite, this is just an estimate. There's so many granite colors, but I picked something kind of moderately priced, not the cheapest stuff you could get. And honestly, you know, you're not going to find, whether it's granite or quartz or anything else, if it's a stone material, it's going to be in a similar price range. If you wanted to use a plastic laminate, I guess I could do that, but I don't think you'd be happy with it. It's terribly outdated looking and not a whole lot less expensive. Not going to save you too much to do that. Backsplash, the area I mentioned where it had tile, I went ahead and priced it full height splash. I can do tile if you want tile. The labor alone is going to put you up there, so figure that number would be more like 1,007 instead of 720. All right. The carpentry, to do most of the work, I think about $5,000. The electrical work, $23,000. Plumbing, 1071. Floors. This is important. Oh, don't look at this yet. I'll explain. Because that totaled up four different numbers. Okay, four different numbers up here. You wouldn't really be doing that. Your little place presents a little bit of a problem to refinish everything at once, as far as your floors go. Because I got to put furniture somewhere. So I could put everything in your bedroom and hall while we finish the large room. And then another day, you could do it differently. We'll work it out. But anyway, just to give you an idea of price, the big room only, which includes, you know, everything except the hall in your bedroom, $1,293 to sand and refinish that. So if you take this number and you add up all the individuals, you come to just a little over 22,000. So you're in the neighborhood at between, let's say, $22,000 and $25,000. You can complete this kitchen. You need to add to that your appliances, and you need to add to that your that's it, appliances. Sink's already included in the top of this counter price. I mean, price of this countertop, and you get a faucet, garbage disposal, refrigerator, so on and so forth. Attached is a copy of this form. It's my retainer. And I believe I explained this to you. If I didn't, it's just so that I know that I'm being paid for my time as we get through this process. If you think you want to move forward, if you want to go ahead and tweak the design or whatever it is you want to do, happy to do it for you. If you're confident you want to work with me, then I ask for your retainer, every dollar of which is going to go towards your purchase, okay? Okay. I think that pretty much does it. I look forward to hearing from you very, very soon. And thanks again. It's about a 10-minute video, so I appreciate you watching it. Bye now.